A very good morning to all of you. I, Zareen Fatima, am a student of MTech Environmental Engineering and Sciences here in the Department of Civil Engineering. It gives me an immense pleasure in welcoming you all to the GIAN course of Managing Floods and Droughts in a Changing Climate being organized by the Department of Civil Engineering, Jamia Millia, Islamia University. GIAN is an acronym of Global Initiative of Aquatic Networks. GIAN is a Hindi word meaning knowledge. The aim of GIAN is to tap the talent pool of internationally renowned scientists and experts to encourage their interaction with young researchers in India and to garner the best international experience into our systems of education and to motivate people to work on the cutting-edge technologies. May I request our honorable dignitaries to please come up to the dais, our respected Vice Chancellor, Professor Talat Ahmed Sir, our course faculty member, Mr. Hans Christian Emmentop, senior hydrologist at DHI Denmark, our chief guest, Shri Pradeep Kumar Sir, member River Management at Central Water Commission, New Delhi, our dean, faculty of engineering and technology, Professor Mehtab Alam, our head, Department of Civil Engineering, Professor Gohar Mahmood Sir, local GIAN coordinator, Professor Mohammed Aman Jai Rajpuri, principal course coordinator, Dr. Azhar Hussain, and Professor Mohammed Sharif. For seeking the blessing of the Almighty, may I request Dr. Mohammed Umair, sir, for the recitation of few verses from the Holy Quran.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Allahu alladhi yursilur riyaha fatuthiru sahaban fayabsutuhu fis samaa'i kayfa yasha'. ويجعله كسفا فترى الودق يخرج من خلاله فإذا أصاب به من يشاء من عباده إذا هم يستبشرون وإن كانوا من قبل أن ينزل عليهم من قبله لمبلسين فانظر إلى آثار رحمة الله كيف يحيي الأرض بعد موتها إن ذلك لمحيي الموتى وهو على كل شيء قدير ولئن أرسلنا ريحا فرآه مصفرا لظلوا من بعده يكفرون.
It is Allah who sends for the wind, who sends forth the winds of hope, so that they raise a cloud whereupon he spreads it over the skies as he wills, and causes it to break up so that you see rain issue from within it. And as soon as he causes it to fall upon whomever he wills of his servants, they rejoice. Even though a short while ago, just before it was sent down upon them, they had abandoned all hope. Behold then, O man, these signs of Almighty's grace, how he gives life to the earth after it had been lifeless. Verily, this self-same Almighty is indeed the one that can bring the dead back to life, for he has the power to will anything. But thus it is, if he send a wind just that scorches their land and they see it turn yellow, they begin after that to deny the truth of our almightiness and grace. And verily, you cannot make the dead hear, and so too you cannot make the deaf of heart hear this call when they turn their backs on you and go away. Sadaqallahul Azim.
May I request Ms. Nausheen Sakina to present a bouquet to our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Talat Ahmed Sir. He is a renowned geologist and fellow of National Academy of Science. I extend a warm welcome to our respected chief guest, Shri Pradeep Kumar, member River Management at Central Water Commission, New Delhi. May I request Ms. Ikra Latif to present a bouquet to our honorable chief guest, Shri Pradeep Kumar. May I request Ms. Fiza Beck to present a bouquet to our course faculty member, Mr. Hans Christian Emmentorp, Senior Hydrologist at DHI Denmark. May I now request Nausheen Sakina to present a bouquet to Professor Gohar Mehmood Sir, Head Department of Civil Engineering. May I now request Ms. Ikra Latif to present a bouquet to Professor Mohammad Aman J. Rajpuri, Local GIAN Coordinator of Jamia Millia Islamia. May I request Ms. Fiza Beg to present a bouquet to Dr. Azhar Hussain, Principal Course Coordinator. May I request Ms. Sabah Rehman to present a bouquet to Professor Mohammad Sharif, sir. Now, starting with the session, may I request Head of the Department, Professor Gohar Mehmood, sir, to welcome the gathering. Please, sir.
Respected Vice Chancellor, Professor Emmentorp, Mr. Pradeep, our chief guest, coordinators, and dear participants, it's indeed a great pleasure that we have this GIAN program over here. In this program, we are emphasizing on drought and flood management. We welcome all our participants with due acknowledgement that we have certain aspects of water in which has got the research and consultancy in the department. In our department, we have core faculties on various aspects of water. Please do interact with them. We are working on river water, groundwater, wastewater, water management, rainwater harvesting, and as many as 90 research students are enrolled here. Every year we are providing about 4 to 5 PhD. That degree is awarded in the field of water. So water is a prime aspect, and of course, in this department, we have the various research program based on the core theme of the water, especially groundwater as well as optimization of the river water. Apart from the reservoir, we have the conservation and development programs of water. Incidentally, Jamia Millia Islamia is the first university of its kind which developed the rainwater harvesting master program. I mean, if you see the micro level analysis of water, because most of you have come first time to Jamia, so please see this program that out of 30 lakh liter per day water, the MCD and gel board supplies only 7 lakh water. 23 lakh liters of water we are managing ourselves. And we are not only controlling the flood, but our tubewells are running successfully. So that means our concentration, our research development, and the research areas in the water is quite visible. Apart from this, the DHI, which is a core organization in the field of hydrology and hydraulics, they are here along with Professor Muhammad Sharif and Professor Azhar. Professor Muhammad Sharif, he has got his degree from Edinburgh. He is working on optimization of water. And Professor Dr. Azhar, he is also working on the various themes of the river. So you will get a sizable knowledge from the core faculty as well as from the DHI. We also welcome the collaborative research. We have got certain collaborative research with the various organizations of the country, like NIH, like CWC, Central Water Commission, Central Groundwater Board. But if at all, from your organization, you want to have some collaborative research program through Jamia, Millia, Islamia, you are welcome. And please do interact with our other faculties, those who are working on water conservation, wastewater, as well as water resource development. Apart from these, there are certain research groups which is working on the various themes of water, especially bioremediation and hydrobotanical aspects. Please do interact with them whenever you are free. So I am asking all my faculty members to be here and interact with the participants. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. May I request Dean Faculty of Engineering and Technology, Professor Mehtab Alam, sir, to address our respected guest and profound gathering.
Good morning. Our Vice Chancellor, Professor Talat Ahmed, Foreign Faculty, Dr. Hans Ementrop, Head of the Department, our very first Dean and Senior Most the first professor of the university, Professor Iqbal Hassan Khan Sahab, proctor, colleagues, participants, ladies and gentlemen. This is also a matter of a great pleasure and satisfaction that the university has organized and conducted very successfully 25 GIAN programs. And this faculty has already conducted 5 GIAN programs from this auditorium. This is the 6th being organized by Civil Engineering Department on this very relevant topic of management of the drought and floods. Overwhelming response from the participants as they have registered more than the required number of seats, much more than that, shows and proves the relevance of the program and its importance. Since the Professor Talat Ahmed joined the university, he has given a lot of emphasis on research. And under his leadership, the university in all the faculties are working very seriously on research and development, particularly the science faculty of natural sciences and social science and faculty of engineering and technology. This course in today's scenario is very, very important. As we know, due to global warming, climate is changing. Sometimes it's too much rain, sometimes too less rain. Rain is concentrated at certain area, causing thereby the floods and droughts. There are a number of reasons. How these floods and droughts are to be managed is a great challenge. We believe from the lectures to be delivered by Hans Ementrop, participate will definitely improve their knowledge on the management of the drought and floods, and will definitely apply this knowledge gained from here for their future research and to face this threat, particularly in our country. I believe the participant will be definitely benefiting, improving their knowledge, and will enjoy this course. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. May I now request Professor Muhammad Aman J. Rajpuri, sir, GIAN coordinator, Jamia Millia, Islamia, to enlighten us about the GIAN program in Jamia Millia, Islamia.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Khan, Professor Gohar Mahmood Saab, Professor Mehtab Alam Saab, and other coordinators, Professor Sharif, Chief Guest Pradeep Kumar Saab from CWC, other colleagues and guests and students. I'll just in a very brief time just try to tell you about the mandate of the program. See the courses. So as Professor Mehtab has already alluded, this is the 26th program which we are having, GIAN course, and which is the highest among the universities in the country. JNU has done 18 programs, so we are this is the 26th. Let me assure you one thing, that there are a couple of things which have been common, and that is that the student has benefited, and we know through feedback and other interactive avenues that the feedback has been excellent for almost all of the courses, and the foreign faculty has generally been very impressed by our students. The point is that this has happened because the course is organized in such a way, right from its inception to conceiving it, and then it goes through an application process, and it is very strictly peer reviewed, and after the peer review it is there is a two-tier peer review which is there for each course, and then the basically the alignment of the course with the local faculty is also an important thing, such that the holistic contribution is taken care of. Like there has to be an alignment of the local faculty or the local course coordinator with the foreign faculty, and most of the courses are which we like for the last 1 month we have had courses on microfinancing and poverty elimination. We have had courses on organic LED, nanotechnology in batteries. So these are all cutting edge areas, and so the setup is such that. Obviously, the foreign faculty, after all this, effort has arrived here. And then there are, among students, there is a hierarchy in terms of, there are faculties who are there, then there are research students, then master's students, even undergraduate. There was a course just a couple of weeks back where we had undergraduate student taking course in cosmology, So the hierarchy is there. So the setup is such that finally, when these two things align, the foreign faculty with his, vastness of this cutting area knowledge, and then the seekers, generally good things happen when you do that. So this is the setup, and generally people have benefited out of it. The onus is mostly on the participants to, extract things from the faculty, because faculty is brimming with all the, knowledge. And it is the participant, they have also come out of their area, they have traveled, they have arrived here. So to basically, go deeper into the, the specifics, and these are, managing flood and drought and climate change, melting of glaciers and elevation of the sea level. These are all, really pertinent and very, important problems, which is, from area to area, it is, they have unique problems which are there. So you have to, imbibe, inculcate, whatever the foreign faculty is saying. Otherwise also you have to, look around, as Professor Gohar Mahmood Saab said, that go to the faculties, identify which are from your own areas and talk to them, don't hesitate, while you are here. Also explore this, people who have come out of Jamia, to explore the campus and then seek people who are from their own areas. So this is just a very small mandate which is there. So I hope, that Like other courses, this will also be a very successful course. And being a local coordinator of this university for this course, I assure you of my full support in case there are any issues or problems. Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. May I now request Dr. Azhar Hussain, sir, to give a brief introduction about this course.
Yes, good morning. The Department of Civil Engineering at Jamia Millia Islamia is proud to host the course on managing flood and drought in change climate under MHRD Global Initiative of Academic Networks, abbreviated as GIAN. According to the fifth assessment report of the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, the frequency and magnitude of floods and droughts are likely to increase under the impact of climate change. Therefore, modeling and management of flood and drought risk is a crucial part of integrated water resources development. Since hydrological modeling can play a vital role in developing effective adaptation and mitigation strategy to counteract the adverse impact of climate change. The major objective of the present course is to introduce the participant to modeling tools that can help to counteract adverse impact of flood and droughts, particularly under the influence of climate change. The specific objective of this course are as follows. Number one, exposing participants to impact of climate change on water resources. Two, strengthening the participant knowledge on water resources management, particularly in addressing flood and drought issues in a changed climate. Three, capacity building in a hydrological information system. Four, providing exposure to practical problems and their solution through the case studies and live projects on water resources management. The course lecture will be delivered by the foreign expert Hans Christian Amentrop, who is a senior hydrologist at DHI Denmark. I am sure that participant will find the course is useful. I wish all the participants at a pleasant time at Jamia Millia Islamia over the next 5 days.
Thank you, sir. Now I invite Professor Mohammed Sharif, sir, to briefly introduce Mr. Christian Hans Emmentorp.
Thank you, Zareen. Good morning to all. It is my pleasure to introduce Hans Christian Emmentorp. Hans Christian Emmentorp is a senior hydrologist at DHI Denmark. Earlier, he served as associate professor at the Asian Institute of Technology in Thailand during 1994 to 1996. Mr. Amantop has more than 30 years of professional experience in water resources management. Over the years, he has contributed to a long range of projects in different parts of the world. He has worked in Europe, Africa, and the Asia-Pacific region, typically within flood management, development of flood forecasting systems, integrated water resources management, establishment of decision support systems. He has held several team leader positions for DHI. His vast international experience has been gained in Algeria, China, the Czech Republic, Germany, India, Iran, Ivory Coast, Indonesia, Malaysia, Malawi, Mali, Poland, Romania, Senegal, Sri Lanka, Slovakia, Sweden, Turkey, Thailand, and Ukraine. So he has worked in almost all parts of the world. He's a very widely traveled person, and we are very pleased to have him here this morning. His work in India started in the mid-1980s, when he worked with the Central Water Commission of Government of India. He worked on a project to install an operational flood forecasting system for the Damodar Valley. And later, he helped CWC develop similar systems for the Yamuna and Godavari rivers as well. All these projects were implemented under a flood modeling package that covered flood mitigation and dam break modeling. He has helped CWC in strengthening modeling capacities in various projects. Hence, Amintop has further participated in World Bank missions to define the hydrology project of the Ministry of Water Resources in 1993 and 1994. He was team leader for the Decision Support System Planning Project under Hydrology Project 2 from 2009 to 2013, in which 6 central agencies and 9 states participated. We are very happy to have him here, and I'm very confident that participants will gain a lot from his knowledge. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. May I now request our course faculty, Mr. Hans Christian Emmentorp, to share his knowledge and expertise in current scenario on climate change and its impact on flood and droughts.
Professor Talat Ahmad, Vice Counselor, Sri Pradeep Kumar, Member RM from Central Water Commission, Professor Guha Mahmood, Head of Department of Civil Engineering, Professor Alam, Dean of the faculty here, Professor Aman Jarajpuri, the Gene Coordinator, Dr. Hussain and Professor Sharif. I'm delighted to be invited here as a course faculty for this GIAN course, where we're going to talk about managing floods and droughts in a changing climate. So it's not just changed, but it's still changing, and probably even changing more than what we have seen so far. This has been a key area for DHI for quite some time now, both in our projects around the world where we are helping different clients in addressing the flooding problem and drought problem that are increasing, not only because the climate is changing, but also because you have more people on the floodplains that are exposed to the floods. You have more people wanting irrigation water, wanting town water supply, wanting hydropower. So there's an increasing pressure on our water resources, not only in India, but throughout the world. DHI, that I work for and has, as you heard, worked for many years, is an organization which is working a bit like a consulting company, but we work not for profit, as we call it. What nobody owns DHI, so whenever we make any revenue on our projects, we can use all that for research and development internally. And that means that whenever we work on a project with our new technology and new methods, there are always challenges that can probably be solved a little better. There are probably methods that can be developed and so on. So we can come back from these projects and start research looking into how can we do this better? Can we further develop our MIC models? Is it the knowledge of this particular process that needs to be improved and so on? So that has made DHI a very interesting place to work, and that's why I'm still there after 30 years. It's been interesting, not least to work here in India, as you just heard. Even from the time when we started with Central Water Commission back in the 80s, and models were a very new thing. To try to apply this in real time to solve the actual problems of the day. I remember this flood forecasting system in the Damodar Valley. We installed this on a computer made by Wipro, and this was the first time they made this kind of computer. And they even made the compiler and all the software, and it was horrible. But after a lot of work, not least by your colleagues from the Central Water Commission, but then also us, we managed to make it work and managed to set up this inflow forecasting system, which enabled increased water levels, actually, in the reservoirs back in the 80s there. And we are happy to see that Central Water Commission is still using our tools after all these years. We are going to go through climate change and floods and droughts, but what I will try in this course is mainly to share the practical knowledge that we have. From the university here, you can get lots of academic background and methods and so on. I'll try to share with you what have we learned in actually solving these problems around the world. What are the issues that you face when you sit there and you have clients that want to help you? So we're going to go through that, and I'm looking very much forward to this. I would like to extend a thanks to Jamia University and not least Professor Sharif to invite me to this historic and prestigious university, and I look very much forward to spending this week with you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for sharing your knowledge with us. It is an honor to have Shri Pradeep Kumar, sir, Member River Management, as a chief guest in this morning. May I request you, sir, to kindly enlighten us with your free word for, with your words of wisdom, please, sir.
Good morning, Vice Chancellor sir, और मंच पर उपस्थित सभी गुरुजनों को मेरा नमस्कार. इस अद्भुत संगम पे मैं अपने क्षेत्र में जो समस्याएं आज की डेट में हम इंजीनियर्स रिवर मैनेजमेंट फ्लड और ड्रॉट को मैनेज करने में झेल रहे हैं वो गुरुजनों के और आप सबके सामने प्रस्तुत करूंगा ताकि हम लोग आगे के भविष्य को आज की तरह जिस तरह हमें ब्लेम किया जा रहा है आप लोगों को ब्लेम ना किया जाए और आने वाली पीढ़ी को ब्लेम किया. अभी हम जो चैलेंज महसूस कर रहे हैं वो ये है कि रिवर्स में सिल्टेशन बहुत हो रहा है. मैं आपको अपना एक पर्सनल एग्जांपल बताता हूँ कि मैं अभी कुछ 8-10 महीने में रिटायर हो जाऊँगा तो मैंने सोचा चलो मैं अपने घर बनारस जाके रहूँगा. चूँकि बूढ़ा होने जा रहा हूँ तो अब इंडियन स्टाइल के टॉयलेट पर नहीं बैठ पाता, सोचा वहाँ पर एक यूरोपियन टॉयलेट बना दूँ. आपको ताज्जुब होगा कि मैं बालू का इंतज़ाम अपने यूरोपियन टॉयलेट को बनवाने के लिए नहीं कर सका और एक तरफ हमारी सारी नदियाँ ये कहा जा रहा है कि उनकी कैरिंग कैपेसिटी कम होती जा रही है. इसका मतलब हमें इस डायरेक्शन में बहुत ज़्यादा रिसर्च की आवश्यकता है कि हम किस तरीके से साइंटिफिकली रिवर से सिल्ट को रिमूव कर सकें, इतना रिमूव करें जिससे कि रिवर की मॉर्फोलॉजी का इम्पैक्ट बुरा ना हो, डाउन स्ट्रीम रीचेज में रिवर्स के कोर्सेज चेंज ना हो और नदियों का अति अधिक कटाव ना होने पाए. चूँकि आप सभी लोग यहाँ पे हैं और माननीय वाइस चांसलर महोदय ने रिसर्च को बहुत बढ़ावा दिया है ऐसा मुझे बताया आप लोगों ने, तो मैं एक प्रार्थना के साथ आपसे रिक्वेस्ट करूँगा कि आगे वाले समय में एक तो जो रिवर की गाद बालू में क्या ऐसे तत्व हैं जिनको हम गेनफुली यूटिलाइज कर सकें, कुछ पोर्शन उधर निकल जाए, इंडस्ट्रीज इस्टेब्लिश हो जाए, कुछ कंस्ट्रक्शन इंडस्ट्रीज़ के साथ लिंक कर सकें कि जिस एरिया में बहुत ज़्यादा कंस्ट्रक्शन हो रहा है वहाँ पे पीपीपी मोड में उस बालू को या उस मिट्टी को या उस गाद को ट्रांसफ़र कर सकें एज़ पर देयर यूज़. तो डिफरेंट रीचेज में रिवर के अंदर कौन सा मटेरियल किस काम आ सका इसके ऊपर भी बहुत रिसर्च की आवश्यकता है. मैं इन्हीं शब्दों के साथ आप लोगों से अनुरोध करूंगा कि इस दिशा में यदि आप लोग कुछ मेरे सहायता कर सकेंगे तो आगे वाले लोगों को ये ब्लेम नहीं होगा. दूसरा एक बहुत बड़ा याद आ गया मुझे भी कंक्लूड करते समय, हम इंजीनियर्स को ये ब्लेम किया जाता है कि स्ट्रक्चरल मेजर्स ऑफ फ्लड प्रोटेक्शन में आप लोग वो काम करते हैं जिसमें पैसा ज़्यादा लगे. तो मैं आप लोगों से अनुरोध करूँगा कि फ्लड प्रोटेक्शन के ऐसे चीप मेथड्स को ईजाद कर सकें, अगर कर सकें जो कि आगे वाली पीढ़ियों को काम आ सकें. धन्यवाद.
Thank you so much, sir. We are delighted to have you among us. We are privileged to have with us our respected Vice Chancellor, Professor Talat Ahmed, sir. Our Vice Chancellor is a renowned geologist and is currently working on many research projects on international repute. May I request you, sir, to kindly give us the presidential address to the gathering.
Good morning and Assalamu Alaikum. Professor Hans, our course expert from Denmark, Shri Praveen Pradeep Kumar ji, the member River Management Central Water Commission, my colleagues on the dais, off the dais, students, participants, as a geologist, I feel it is very timely and important GIAN program being organized by our colleagues from Engineering College, particularly the university is now working on many aspects of climate change and disaster management. We have started a course which is, I think, diploma at present for disaster management related to climate change. See, there is lots of change happening all over the world, and we don't have real enough data to predict anything, particularly the extreme events that happens, which cannot be modeled. And it will be a very challenging thing even to have a long-term understanding until unless we have long-term data to understand the climate change and the effects of these climate change on our different resources, in particular water. As you can see that over the time, we have been getting floods for a few years and droughts for a few years. In some part it is flooded, in other parts of the country there is drought. So how all the dynamics that is happening needs to be understood. And also with the climate change, how it is impacting the glaciers, because we know that our big resource of potable water is in the glaciers. And whether we really understand what is happening because of the greed of people to cut the trees, in particularly in the mountainous region. And as our chief guest, Pradeep Kumarji, was talking of siltation, because of indiscriminate cutting of the plants, you have erosion of the Himalayas, and most of the rivers, they have become shallow because of the indiscriminate flooding and bringing lots of silt from the Himalayas and dropping it in the river course. And if you have even less rain at some time, we have flood because the rivers have become shallow. So it is a challenge how to desilt. There are lots of pilot projects being done, but I think it is a challenging area for the country. I would suggest Dr. Hans that Damodar is one area where you will never get flood. So whatever model you do is not going to be so much useful than if you can model, say, Budhi Gandak or about the Himalayan rivers that is coming out of the, you know, the Ganges and Yamuna. That will be a real challenging thing, and we will be very happy to join hands with you and the CWC to do some of these aspects at Jamia Millia. We have a very strong group in the geography department, and we are trying to build more understanding about the earth surface processes. You see, the engineers will build dams and they will build bridges and all, but until unless you understand the geology and the rocks and the soil that is being carried, you are not going to have all the answers. So it is better to have more multi-institutional and multidisciplinary approach, because climate change cannot be understood, nor the disaster can be taken care of by either scientists or the engineers or the social scientist or anybody alone. It has to be a combined work. I am very sure that Professor Hans will be touching upon some of these practical issues, because he has been working in different parts of the world and he has also worked in our country. And I hope the faculty members, the students, and the researchers from different institutions will take benefit of his presence. Don't feel shy to ask questions. Because if you don't ask questions, after 5 days he is gone, then your questions will be in your mind and nobody will reply. So ask and try to use his presence. I hope that you will all have a very rewarding stay at Jamia Millia, and the country will benefit out of the knowledge that will be produced during these discussions. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. I request Professor Mohammad Sharif, sir, to deliver a vote of thanks.
I consider it a great privilege to propose a vote of thanks in this inaugural function of GIAN course on managing floods and droughts in a changing climate. Our first gratitude is to our Honorable Vice Chancellor, who has always been very supportive of all our academic endeavors. Thank you very much, sir, for your encouragement, guidance, and providing a stimulating environment in the university for such academic developments. We are greatly encouraged by your gracious presence this morning. I express my sincere thanks to our chief guest, Shri Pradeep Kumar, Member River Management Central Water Commission, for gracing this occasion. Thank you very much, sir. We are extremely thankful to Hans Ementoff for agreeing to deliver these lectures despite his very, very busy schedule. I would like to thank our Dean, Professor Mehtab Alam, and Head of our Department, Professor Gaur Mahmood, for their support and guidance during the preparations for this course. I'm happy to express a vote of thanks to all my colleagues, volunteers, staff members, and students for their help in organizing this event. Thanks are also due to Professor Aman Jairajpuri, who has always been available to us for answering all our queries on GIAN program. I would also like to thank Professor Iqbal H. Khan, Founder Dean, Faculty of Engineering and Technology, for gracing this occasion. Thank you, sir. Finally, I thank all the participants who have come from different organizations and institutes to attend this course.